Welcome back to the channel, Crypto Trend Trader, with a quick update on Bitcoin. Before we get started, I'd like to remind you, it's not financial advice. I'm not your financial advisor, whose markets are extremely volatile, so please do your own research and trade responsibly. I just want to start off by saying thanks to everybody. We did hit the 500 subscriber mark. We've been around just about a year now, and the amount of growth and interactions that we have, the watch time, the community, just the amount of resources that we have available at our disposal is absolutely phenomenal. And I appreciate every single one of you. Even the one person I know exactly who you are who watches every single one of my videos and gives me a thumb down. Honestly, I appreciate you too. And when you're ready to rejoin the positive side of the community, get back on board and we'll just act like it never even happened. So, but anyway, back to it. If you need to get a hold of me, you can go over to the main page and just go to the About section. And if you click on the About section and you hit the View Email Address right here, you can click on the email address and then it will show my actual email. I just don't want to post it in like chat and stuff like that because like bots go through and scan for email and then you end up on some list and you just get plagued with, you guys know what happens with bots because you see how often I have to block them on my videos. So just putting your email address out there is just dumb, so I don't do it. So there you have it. That's the email right there. It's cryptotrendtrader@gmail.com. So you can just message me on there if you are interested. So, and I do appreciate the support and the outreach from everybody. You know, my intention is honestly just to put that right back into, an upgrade setup and, be full on basically like live streaming and put my face on the videos and get all the basically upgrade the channel. I figure a year in, the amount of time, content, dedication, feedback, everything, it's time to spring this thing to the next level. So that's what we're going to do. So very excited about it. And you will see those upgrades and changes in the very near future. And honestly, I think that's what's going to basically like catapult us into the future. So, all right, we're going to get rid of that and we're going to do a little bit of technical analysis. Now, and that's what this is really all about for me, is essentially just keeping the main channel free. No ads, no shilling, none of that trash, no selling anything, not trying to get you to do referral links. Real quick, I want to touch with you guys and just let you know, with how small my channel is, I get constantly message from people, exchanges, whatever, trying to pay me anywhere from 200 to 500 on the low end to like 1,000 to 2,000 on the high end to make a video about their product or their exchange or their coin and to share it and to basically like shill it. So I just want you to know that, you know, I get those hit up with those all the time and I refuse them. So whenever you see that all over the place and people doing all these shill stuff, they're probably doing it for, you know, bigger channels, but I'm sure are making like 5 or 10 grand or whatever. But just let it be known that they're literally doing that just as like a shill paid ad. So they're just making money off of that, which that's totally cool. That's totally cool. But I cannot stand when every 2 seconds there's an ad or there's 15 straight minutes of you like pitching your, you know, course in the middle of a video or, you know, just one thing after another every single time. It's just so ridiculous. And it's nonstop, it seems like, in this space. It's like all of a sudden mainstream realized that they need to advertise in a different way. And now they have just plagued the entire like space. It's absolutely ridiculous. You can't go anywhere now, it seems like, without just getting bombarded with, you know, ads and shills nonstop. So but anyway, here we are on the 4 hour. Everything's playing out exactly like we talked about. We basically came up, failed at the 618, came back down. Here we are at the moving averages. You can see very clearly the 50 exponential is exactly what we've been cruising across on here. We touched on a couple times on the 55, essentially the 55, you know, that last touch right here, but the exponential has just been getting every single one of these moves basically to the T. So we got the cross down here confirmed. Essentially what we're looking at right now is on the jewel thief, the blue is getting ready to cross above the purple. If we get a successful cross here, we usually get a nice burst up, like right away we'll always get like, you know, a nice little 2 or 3%, like just nice burst. But what could alternatively happen is this essentially either flips right back over to the bottom or it gets rejected right here and just sells off, which is honestly like what it looks like is going to happen right now. So essentially what I think happening is we came down here, we found support, we're attempting to bust back up and we're getting rejected. So as we're getting rejected below the moving averages and we're confirming this cross, we're also, you know, basically setting up for a rejection on the jewel thief. And then at the same time, the TJD, TD, MACD has us in a strong downtrend with no positive green on the histogram whatsoever yet. So the likelihood, you know, this is essentially like the relief rally histogram right here in green, and then we don't have anything going on now. So it looks like very clearly like we're going to come down here next and test the 89 at 10.655 or whatever. So that's my next target in the very near future. We could find like some support at the 236, as we have been very clearly interacting with the Fibonacci's. That would put us at the 10.893, so 10.9 range. But in all reality, I mean, the main target is it has always been down here at the 89. But again, we could have like support at, I mean, 10, all these ranges, it's basically just a cluster of support in between here and there. So we basically oscillate around in this actual range right here, you know, see where the close is at. We haven't had a lower close yet on the 4 hour. So if all of a sudden at noon, the next 30 minutes, it starts selling off, if we close this 4 hour below 11,062, which is like $30 below where we're at right now, we're going to see continuation to the downside, because we're going to have put in a high, we're going to have put in a low, a lower high, and then a lower low. It's going to look like on the micro of this move right here. So essentially what that's going to do is just tell the market that we're going to continue to the downside until we find adequate support. Now, we did previously on like previous runs, we had a like kind of push up like this, and then a massive sell-off got bought up, and then we continued straight to the moon. But honestly, I don't think that's what's going to happen here. This is not what it looks like. It's still possible at this point in time, but it doesn't look like that. It doesn't look like a fat finger stop punt, anything like that. It looks more like a blow off top into alt, and then basically like I think we're going to come back into Bitcoin as this sells off, and we're going to see like a huge fluctuation in the Bitcoin dominance. But at this point in time, this doesn't look bullish to me short term. It looks bullish to me long term, long term, but it doesn't look bullish to me on short time frame, 4 hour quite yet. It's getting close, but I'd like to see a little divergence. The daily is bearish. We're basically selling off. We have red histograms. We're above the slope, so it still is bullish long term. But you know, we're in the distribution zone. We had a massive poke up from the knife, and then we're getting ready for the hard sell to the downside. So if we exit the distribution zone right here, which is exactly where the cross is going to take place at the 80, that's basically going to be like one of the most reliable signals that you can get from this indicator. So I would still like to honestly see divergence. Also, I'd like to see a knife stab back up here, an attempt back to the upside, with like a green histogram and a green knife stab, a higher high and a lower knife stab. But I don't know if we're going to get that this time. I mean, that's like the perfect signal. But between all these together and the moving averages, essentially, it looks like what's going to happen is if we find support right here at 11,075, we're going to continue to the upside. But if we break through that 8 moving average, we're going to come down to the daily 21. And the daily 21 lines up perfectly with the parabolic SAR, like the green SAR. So if we come down to 10,508, basically, come down to 10,500. We're going to take out the green SAR, and we're going to hit the 21 moving average. That's where I would expect a solid bounce from, because that's going to line up perfectly with the heart line of the channel as well. So this little cluster right here is our target, and I'm looking to take at least a scalp long off of that, if not like a full-on continuation to the upside trade. But regardless, that's the area I'm looking at right now. And then let's just flip over real quick to the weekly. Weekly, essentially, we're coming up here. We're going to attempt to take out this high again. We failed to get the higher high close on the weekly. We got it on the monthly on traditional markets. We failed to get it on the weekly. So now we have a whole week of indecision where this could essentially pump up and then leave a massive wick behind. And then it comes down here, and then it's just confirming another lower high and sells off. So that's what we're looking for. And then weekly, we've got basically we have the hard sell now in this case on the weekly. The blue has crossed below the purple, but we do have a strong trending upside on the monthly. So that definitely looks good. We are also above the red slope line now with the histogram and trending to the upside, although the slope is still to the downside. If we can stay above it long enough and consolidate here, we will flip it back over blue, and we'll get continuation to the upside and a massive bull run to follow. Once this flips over blue on the weekly, it's game on. And then monthly, once again, we managed to save the histogram. We got the histogram back above the blue, got the histogram back above the blue over here, but we still failed and came down and put that in. But when we did, we put in a higher low. So we could potentially fail again here, sell off and get another massive wick or just a solid body close. But as long as we put in a higher low, we're still trending to the upside on the monthly. And then as you can see, we got like the fake out or the failed flipped to the downside. It basically crossed to the downside and then immediately crossed back to the upside. So as of now, it looks like we have basically bounced it and we saved the cross to the downside, and we're going to get continuation to the upside, which is typically a very strong and powerful signal. And with the histogram above the blue slope line and that in line on the monthly time scale, Bitcoin is extremely bullish and I would expect continuation. And if you look at the last time, basically, we got, well, it's too hard to, I'm not going to get into all that right now, but you know, we're talking about basically like this type of continuation, like continuation after like the initial blow off top, and then, you know, start rallying back up to potentially take out all time highs. So we're right about here. We're basically at the parabolic SAR. We just got the buy. We're in this area right here. And essentially all we need to do is take out that parabolic SAR, find support, and then get continuation on the monthly. Take out that parabolic SAR. That's at 13,300. So if we take out 13,300, we're going to flip this parabolic SAR over green. Overall, it looks bullish on the long time frames. Does not look bullish on the medium time frames. And starting to look bullish on the shorter time frames. But I still expect continued sell-off. So, well, there you have it, guys. You know how to reach out to me. We're only going to do 5 people. I'm going to keep it small. I think we're pretty much full at this point in time. But just message me on there. If you have or haven't already or whatever, and I'll get a hold of you guys. I'm obviously going to, choose people that have been more interactive in chat and have like a desire to, you know, learn and grow the community and everything, because, you know, I appreciate that they've already been giving back. So there you have it, guys. I really appreciate everything. And over time, we'll expand everything out. But the goal is not to shift into like a paid group situation. The goal is to keep everything free for the masses and to allow like a few people that want a little more to help out the entire community by, essentially like upgrading the content. That's the goal. And I'm willing to put out, you know, extra time and dedication and effort to help those people in any way that I can, you know, essentially to reciprocate them springshotting the channel. So that's the idea behind this. You know, all the money is going to get flipped right back into it and you're going to see it. And the other option was to show one of these junk exchanges, make some video, put a referral link at the bottom and get paid, you know, a couple grand and then go out and buy the computer with that. But it just seems like very little amount of money to sell out for, in my opinion, to endorse something that I don't know and don't know. I would literally rather break my own, you know, agreement that I was just going to put my time into this channel and allow it to grow organically without putting money into it, rather than sell out. I would literally rather have 500 subscribers for the next year and wait and take my time and grind slow than add all these commercials and shills and ads and all this junk to where you guys cannot honestly even trust my credibility. Because if there's one thing you know right now, you know that I literally have your best interest in mind, and there's no other reason for me doing this. I'm doing this to share my knowledge with you guys, to grow the community, and, you know, potentially like reciprocate like growth. Well, there you have it, guys. Crypto Trend Trader, a little technical analysis on Bitcoin. Be very careful as always. We are below the moving averages. We did get the confirmed cross to the downside. So at this point in time, what I would expect is continuation until we can find support. Once we find support, you know, this has been a powerful uptrend. So I wouldn't quite write it off yet, although this is starting to look more and more like a topping, pattern. And then, you know, take into account like fundamentals, traditional markets, everything that's going on. And, who knows? TA might be out the window. Maybe it's more reliable than ever. Depends who you ask, I guess. So, Crypto Trend Trader,
and I'm out of here.